Okay, so this is our cabaret burlesque using gloves. And to begin with, we are going to be looking saucy. So you begin with both gloves on, and we're going to start with the side of our body to the audience. So you get a nice little twist. Don't forget to keep the abs in. Lovely. And we're going to be pushing our hip up. So it's nice to have one hand resting, and also it pulls your shoulder back. So rather than being like that, you're really twisting your torso to face your audience. Okay, and find a position that your hand and arm like. So we're going to push up, two, three, four. Then we're going to switch side. Okay, and do three hip raises on this side. One, two, three. Shikada, shikada. So again, you really want to twist your torso to face your audience. Okay, lovely, nice little bit of that. Nice. So again, it's starting with, so it's quite easy because this is our, we're starting in this position, so we're already starting in a pose. It's quite nice to start with hand across like that, so that when you begin the hit, you can just bring that hand out. But it's more comfortable as well, waiting for music to start like this. Okay, my darling. So get comfy in your starting pose, and we'll do four hip raises, swivel, three hip raises, jiggity jiggity. All righty, here we go with the music. Switch side. One, two, three. Lovely, lovely, no problems there. So the next part, we are already in the pose. We've done our jiggity jiggity, but we're going to stay here because we're looking good. And we're just going to open our arms out so that we can do some of those hip circles and just rolling it back. Okay. And I find with hip circles, the deeper you sink, the cheekier they look. So you can do a little side one, or you can really go for it. Okay, lovely. I'm not sure how many of those we do. I think it's about three, but it depends how fast you're doing them. And then we're going, oh, I tell a lie. Or do I? Actually, she says, make me invisible. So before we do our hip roll, we've got to cover our face, okay, because you're very shy. So make me invisible, but then we're going to flutter our fingers apart, and that brings our arms open to do the hip rolls. Okay, darlings, lovely. And then when we've done our hip rolls, we just turn to face our audience and we run our hands down our bodies as we swish. Nice figure of eights. I shall recap. So from the very top, we're to the side, but twisting so our torso faces our audience, hands on hip. So it's up, two, three, four, switch side up, two, three, jiggity, jiggity. Then sit low, make me invisible, but flutter the hands apart. I feel so, no, I can't remember the word there. And then she turns to, we turn to face, I feel so wonderful. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Let's do that with the music. So from the top, posing and looking lovely. Here we go. Switch side. Shake it out. Very nice, very nice. Should we do that again? So from the top, my friends, from the top.
Like sky, you make my day.
Faith.
I feel so wonderful. Oh, oh, darling.
Very nice, very nice. I think we've got that nailed. So when she goes, uh-oh, we're going to wag our finger and hit side to side. Uh-oh, don't let go. Don't let go, we got a hug. And then have a little wriggle down. Okay, so it's that simple. So we've just got to add that on to our flutter apart, hip roll back. I feel so wonderful. And then bring the feet together, don't let go. It looks cuter if you sit down. Don't ask me why, it just does. Okay. All right, my lovelies. So we'll add that. So we'll go from the top because it's such a short sequence. And we'll starting twisted to our audience and looking beautiful. Love. And don't forget the posture, darling. So when you're sideways, you really need to make sure that you've got a little bit of a tuck and the abs are pulled in as nicely as they can be. All righty. Here we go. Change side. Shake it out.
You make me invisible. Like the sky, you make my day. I feel so wonderful. Oh, oh, don't let go. Don't see you in the dark of you.
Lovely. And if you can, try and avoid the simpering face that I can't stop wearing. Oh, what the heck. It's fun. That was really nice, everyone. We'll do that one more time, just so you feel comfortable with that before we move on. Here we go, from the top then. Remember those abs when you're in sideways. You want to look good, tailbone tuck. Here we go. Change side. Shake it out.
You make me invisible. Like the sky, you make my day.
Face front.
I feel so wonderful.
Wag that finger.
Oh, oh.
Hug.
Don't let go. I'm seeing in the dark with you.
Right, my darlings, this is where we are going to strip off, woohoo, our first glove. So you have to do it as if it's no effort whatsoever. So I always say, don't have the fingers rammed right down. Try and have them a little bit loose so that when you've got to pluck them, you can do so quite quickly. Okay, so a little bit flappy at the end there, but much easier to pluck off. So we're going to obviously be, we're not standing still, we're moving, and we're going to be pushing our hip up with an alternate step. Okay, and at the same time, you've got to pull the gloves off in 3 seconds. So it'll be 1, 2, 3. You should have your glove ready. So it's a quickie. Okay, we're going to hold it above us. She says something about sunshine. So we're going to go down, across and up into a hip washing machine. Okay. And what do we do? Oh, yes. And then we're going to travel backwards. We're going to tiptoe backwards. If you're really limited for space, kind of do this all on the spot. So we're going to kind of camel, but reversing as you camel is quite awkward. So if you find that tricky, just tiptoe back nice and discreetly. But Things are never straightforward. We have a glove to play with, and therefore we're going to be bringing it seductively down the body as we move backwards. So here we go. Okay. So it's going to be very irritating for you, but we're going to have to keep putting our gloves on and off. So get that glove back on, my darlings. Don't ram the fingers down. Make sure you can pluck it off in three steps. And here we go. So we will be coming. So it's a little step with the hip raise. I'm going to take the gloves off. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Above, hip washing machine. And then tiptoe back or on the spot as you bring the glove down. Alrighty. Nice. So I'll take the time code so it's just before that bit. So we will have been, we'll wag our fingers and have our wriggle down. And then we'll start stripping. Okay, here we go. So time code.
Feels so wonderful.
Very nice, very nice, very nice. So we've got a little bit of uh-uh-ohs, but we're going to do it differently because we have a glove to play with. So we've stepped back, bringing it down. We're now going to bring it to frame just under the chest. Okay. And with our uh-uh-oh, it's going to be with our chest. We're going to wag our chest. Uh-uh-oh. Don't let go. Get a little circle if you can. If there's, you don't feel there's time, just go uh-uh-oh. Don't let go. Just hold it. If you feel you can get a little circle in there, then do so. Then we're going to hold it to our hip level. And we're going to tug, as we hit our hip side to side, we're going to tug the scarf side to side. Don't let go. Again, a little hip washing machine. Okay, so I shall summarize that. So that you don't have to put your glove on and take it off again, we'll imagine that we've just tiptoe cameled back, and then we go, don't let go, hip height, don't let go. Okay, and then we're ready for some fun. Alrighty, so we'll practice that verse again. Sorry, girls, you're going to have to put your gloves back on again. So we'll go from the first wag, don't let go, and then start stripping our glove off. So we'll practice that section again. Alrighty. If you get really annoyed with the gloves, you can just pretend your glove is on your hand. Right, here we go. We're ready to put that with the beginning. So sorry, girls, gloves back on. Then I'll shortly show you the chorus and how we get rid of it. Alrighty, gloves at the ready. So going from the very top in our pose, all ready. Here we go, my friends. Change side. Shake it out. Fabulous. Fabulous. We are now ready to do a little bit of flirty glove furling and possibly some dangerous high kicking. So make sure that you have plenty of space around you, that you're not going to knock anything offline. And if you don't want to do a full-on high kick, then you can do a knee raise instead. That still looks cute, okay? So you can either do a knee raise, or if you want to go full pelt, we're going to do high kicks. And as I said, especially with low ceilings, that's always a risk. Right, so my notes is literally over the page. It's really annoying. So we're going to swing it to the side as we kick four. So it'll be one, two, three, four. And then wide legs. We're going to bend forward with our glove in front. And we're going to shoulder shimmy. Okay. So it goes, two hearts are beating together. And that's when she says, I'm in love. So it's, I'm in love. Carly does it a bit better than me, but only a bit. Okay. I'm in love. Ooh. And then she says, I'm in love again. So we're going to bring the scarf behind the neck. Just hold it there. And it goes, I'm in love. Woo! A nice subtle groin shake. Nice little hip shimmy there. All right. So we'll practice from that point. So you don't have to put your glove back on. It's all handy. And are you ready? That will be four high kicks or knee kicks. Followed by, I'm in love. Ooh, I'm in love. Ooh. Oh, I have such a sexy way of saying it. So, starting from our high kicks, my darlings. Yes. Yes, that's perfect. That is perfect. Okay. So we've got it behind our neck already. So what we're going to do, we're just going to wriggle down with it still on our neck. Just do a nice little cute little wriggle. And then she's going to say, I'm in love again. So we're going to swivel to one side. And bend over, nice and provocative. And do you know what that booty needs? It needs a good slap. Exactly. Exactly, it had to be. So we're going from, actually, imagine we've just done the high kicks. We'll go, I'm in love, ooh. I'm in love, ooh. Is this forever and ever, I think she says. Is this forever and ever? Bend over. I'm in love. Ooh. And then we turn our back and slap the other hip. Ow. That was too strong. It's always tricky when you're trying to follow on screen, you have to turn your back to it. But if I hear slaps, I know everyone's doing it. Recapping, chorus, from the kicks, gloves at the hand, handy. Are you ready for a bit of twirling and a bit of kicking? Here we go. One, two, three, four. I'm in love, ooh. I'm in love, ooh. Wriggle down, is this forever and ever? Bend over, I'm in love. Slap, turn your back, slap. Ow, I did it again, too strong. And it is nice to turn and look at your audience. So if you're trying to see what I'm doing at the same time, if you turn your body, it's like, Look what I'm doing. Shall we have a go with the music? Yeah. Okay, my darlings. So going from your high kicks. And try not to slap too hard. It's going to get very sore. Darlings, the chorus is in two parts. That is the first part, but I think it would be a really good idea to go right back to the start so you have a context and remember everything that came before. So yes, it is time to put the glove back on. Here we go. All primed, ready to go. Get into position, you lovely creatures. And I'll see if I can get this to work with the glove on. And remember, don't have the fingers down too deep because you've got to be able to pull it off quite easily. Here we go. Okay, the perfect version. Here we go from the start. Lovely posture, tailbone tucked, tummy in, twisted to face your audience, and just enjoy.
See you.